Good morning, everybody. I've been asked to outline the major governance issues related to the successful development of the IT and to share best practices. What I can share with you is only, of course, only the point of view of a private company coming with a very specific competitive space, dealing with what we have to imagine as a set of disruptive technologies enabling this third platform, how IDC calls the combination of cloud, mobile, big data, and social technologies. A place where one third of the future business will be managed by 2020, mainly. This biased point of view is relevant because IoT will be shaped, and it is shaped right now, mainly by private companies trying to establish a clear leadership in their own space, and by companies trying to leverage these technologies to transform their own specific industries. So, why the business point of view matters? Business leaders worldwide understand that the IoT represents a massively disruptive technology. Cisco alone estimates that the Internet of Everything will generate $14 trillion in economic value or business opportunity over the next 10 years. Apple, Google, Microsoft, and the likes are eager to establish their de facto standards. And to a certain extent, this is inevitable and goes with the consolidation and the material realization of this market opportunity. Still, IoT represents also a great opportunity to facilitate smarter living, helping us to address global and social challenges, making Europe, for example, a more sustainable and inclusive economy. So we need the right directions to stimulate the development of the IoT in a way that best supports Europe's growth and job objectives and contribute to addressing social challenges while ensuring trust and security, including the respect of fundamental rights. Now, the smart city application and services market alone could grow to $3.3 trillion by 2025. So smart cities are retooling their communication infrastructures with the aim of better managing municipal energy, waste, traffic, and so forth. IoT, therefore, represents an opportunity for all of us to develop new jobs and new competencies such as network design, data analysis, data security, and engineering. Now, coming to regulation. Existing regulations have been shaped mainly in order to manage human communication. So are the infrastructures, the telecommunication infrastructure. We only recently have been moving from managing voice traffic to carry videos. IoT is a convergence of cloud, sensors, platforms, networks, data storage, and management, enabling massive and ubiquitous, albeit right now sometimes with low throughput per device, machine-to-machine communications. It's a major change. So we need a regulatory framework designed to support this huge incoming transformation with respect to infrastructures, licenses, rules, procedures. Since the business models that we envisage are different, are way different, so it must be the regulation. Since IoT is going to have a huge impact on transforming non-digital industries, we need to take care of their regulatory frameworks too. For example, let's consider the utility sector and the impact IoT is having on metering and it could have in the development of the smart cities. Now, energy regulators are not TLC regulators. Not very often they talk together with each other. So, regulators and policymakers of ICT and energy should cooperate in order to exploit this transformational power of the IoT. There are a few questions that arise and have been raised by the previous speakers. I would like to focus on data, privacy, identity, and standards from the private company point of view. With respect to data, who owns data? Who administers them? Who determines how data standards are set, how data is organized, how it's kept, where it's kept, and who can see it and use it, and for what purposes? Then there are the not so subtle issue of who owns the derivative information about the data, like the emergent patterns in data and the implications of those patterns. So basically, that's a very admittedly complex issue, but it's relevant to create or not a market. Privacy, are we sure that the existing asymmetric set of rules are well designed to address the incoming transformations. How regulations may cope with the changes in consumer behavior, with some customers very willing to renounce privacy, maybe in exchange for an economic or social return, or for nothing, while others may be very conservative about their own privacy. To what extent ethical motivations should win against freedom of individuals, and how to protect those less cultured? Identity is the other side of the coin. There are currently several initiatives, many of them in Europe, to give us digital identity as digital citizens. But we are already complex entities, each of us, made of ourselves plus several sensors and actuators exchanging information and doing things in the real world. Now, these sensor actuators will belong to us, not always, basically, as well as the actions that they will perform on our behalf. So, our digital identity must somehow include all these objects, links and relations. And regulations must evolve accordingly, avoiding to maintain the existing geographical distortion and fragmentation. Coming to standard definition, the real Internet of Things, meaning the wide availability and exchange of information among the different devices and sensors in order to better serve an individual or an entity, private or public, will not happen as soon as we expect because the lack of standards will prevent adoption on a broader scale. We can't have smart cars, smart cities, and widely connected, well-functioning systems if these parts don't fit together. While there are a few companies that would like to set de facto and worldwide standards, it's deeply needed that regional and local authorities implement policies granting or at least favoring interoperability among platforms and applications. IoT cannot remain, I think, a collection of different independent verticals, applications, and platforms. In order to unleash its full potential, these solutions have to interact and to interoperate in order to make possible the delivering of a new, enhanced user experience, and in order to help companies to increase quality of life of the individuals. We cannot forget that there are major differences in the economic, industrial, and regulatory policies in world different regions. For example, in the US there are sort of four major telecommunication operators, more than 100 in Europe. Attitude towards privacy is different in each of the world's region, and in the European Union is different in each state. And this is the case for identity too. The issue of telecommunication against OTT players is well known. These asymmetries will contribute to shape the supply side of the OTT, and the OTT realm is ubiquitous and often implies mobility, and depending on the application may be largely sovereign national. So, how can we ensure a level of competing field that will allow private companies to compete on a fair basis? Which are the clear rules that will regulate and to what extent the new markets enabled by the IoT? And who will be in charge of forging them? Companies invest in infrastructures only if there is a clear and predictable economic return. They need to foresee a relevant market ahead, significant economies of scale, and some sort of sustainable competitive advantage. Particularly in Europe, a possible answer, or at least a direction to look forward to, would be to the realization of a single digital market, at least for the IoT, in order to make a stronger use of the best European asset, a single market stretching over a whole continent with 500 million potential consumers. While the European market offers already a lot of benefits to Europeans, this is not yet true when it comes to digital products and services, and is not going to be true with regards to IoT, for what we can see so far. Europe today does not have one, but 28 digital markets, regulated mainly nationally. We continue to have in Europe 28 national telecoms regulators, 28 national privacy authorities, 28 consumer protection laws for the internet. I think it's a complex environment. So the internet is global, and the IoT too. Still, Europe believes it can afford fragmented regulation 28 times for digital products and services as well. So I think that what we need is more Europe in telecom regulation, in the application of competition law, and in privacy matters. Only in this way we can we will be in the condition to face the regulatory asymmetry that helps the existing internet giants and marginalize all other companies. As President Jean-Claude Juncker said, Europe has to be big on big issues in the future. Very, very good. The digital single market is a big issue. It is the key to unlock the door to a European future of innovation, job growth, and competitiveness. IoT, it is really a strong business enabler, but to exploit this opportunity, our private companies, all private companies, must be given a stable, clear, and not fragmented, favorable regulatory framework specifically designed to unleash the IoT full potential.
Minus 2 minutes, I'm sorry.
Excellent, excellent.